for your last home visit.
Oh, we do, that's it.
Yeah.
You asked.
We'll give him it later.
They may last it.
They may, bro.
How about the phone?
Well, I tell you what, we're going to say 12 o'clock, we got to find something to eat.
Yeah.
I agree with that, I agree.
He said, "You always think for 12."
Traveling on, and sometimes on a cloud.
Sent out this way, you know, because when you think about it tonight, we serve a sovereign God.
Amen.
We're not here tonight just by happenstance or just by circumstance tonight. We're here because God has placed us in this place. And you say, well, you know, I'm here, yeah, because I came of my own free will. Well, you thought that.
That's right.
But I'm going to tell you, it was God that directed all these paths and all these things to lead you to this place where you are tonight. Now, I don't know where you stand with the Lord, you know, but let me tell you that time is something that's very, very important. Time is something that we take for granted. You know, when Solomon looked back all through his life there in Ecclesiastes chapter 4, he said, vanity, vanity, all is vanity, because he knew as he looked across his life and all that great wealth and all those things that, you know, he had enjoyed in his life, he knew that he was getting ready to leave them to someone else. You know, it's much the same to us. The young ones that are here tonight, they say to themselves, well, I'm young, Pastor. I don't have to worry about these things. You know, Pastor, you know, I'm strong and I'm young and I don't have to worry. How many have said that last year? And aren't here to be with us, you know, tonight. How many said that last year and we miss them in those seats they used to sit in at school? How many have said that to themselves and, you know, went on home to be with the Lord? And then there's those that I believe God wholeheartedly knew that they were going to be with Jesus. And I'm going to tell you tonight, I don't know where you stand with the Lord. But time is an important thing, 1,440 minutes in a day. And why can't we take one and remember what Jesus Christ did for us?
Yes.
Tonight, I don't know where you stand with the Lord. I don't know if you're saved or if you're lost. I can't look down across the crowd and into your heart and see that. But Jesus knows. And he knows the day. He knows the hour. He knows the moment when you'll breathe your last breath. And that heart will beat no more. And tonight, you know, if you don't know him, I'm going to tell you, they sung songs tonight that talks about us going home to be in that place that God has created for us. We talked about tonight, you know, those new glorified bodies that we're going to receive. And boy, I thank the Lord for that, because of this one, it's just breaking down more and more every day.
Yes.
But you know, tonight, when you think about it here, you know, there's only one way that we can receive that blessing. It's called heaven. There's only one way that we'll ever, you know, see our those loved ones that's gone home to be with the Lord tonight, and that's to know Jesus Christ in our heart as our personal Savior. You see, it's not coming to an altar and just, you know, having a good cry. It's not being dunked into the baptismal pool. It's not putting money into that offering plate or church attendance tonight. It's not anything that you can do for yourself or that you could ever work your way. But it's through what Christ did on the cross that made the way for you to go to heaven tonight. And I don't know where you stand with the Lord, but tonight they get ready to sing a song, and they're going to sing it by way of invitation. And when they start singing, I'm going to put down this mic, and I'm going to hush my mouth. But tonight, if you don't know Christ, you don't have a relationship with him, and there's never been a time in your life, I'm going to tell you, what better time would it be? You know, we're in the new year.
Amen.
How would it feel tonight just to lay those burdens down? You know, was last year really that good that there's anything in it that you want to hold on to? You know, I'm going to tell you, the good things are just ahead. It's that place called heaven. It's being there with the one. We're able to look into the eyes of the one that forgave us. You know, it's going on home to be there and be able to rejoice with those that went on home before us. Tonight, what in the world, if you don't know Christ, will keep you in that place for the last year, last moment? That hour is passing. Tonight, if you don't know Christ, get to know him before it's everlasting too late.
Yes. Right.
Father, Lord, as we come to you tonight, Lord, you know the hearts that are here tonight. Jesus, Lord, you know, Lord, even before we knew, Lord, you knew us. And Father, Lord, you said in your word that you thank the Father because all them that he had given you, you've not lost the one. And Father, tonight, if there's one here that's lost and undone, one that don't know you as their personal Savior tonight, one that's maybe walked away off of that path, Lord, that you placed them on. Father, Lord, I pray tonight, Lord, that you help them to make those things right. And Lord, I pray, Lord, if they've not received that atonement, if they don't know what the blood of Christ means to them, Father, Lord, I pray that you'll reveal that to them tonight. And Lord, we pray it in Jesus' name. Amen. If you'll keep your head bowed, eyes closed. And tonight at invitation, they get ready to sing. As they sing tonight, I'm going to hush. Why don't you just step out of your seat tonight? Why don't you come? If you have a need, come now. Go ahead.
Oh. church. We love being here.
We love all of you.